You know, I grew up in the Dominican Republic, and we had cable, so we watched, you know, regular cable TV, you know, that's from America. And growing up, I never saw anyone that, like, represented me or looked like me or, wow, I want to be like her, you know, when I grow up, or what a cool character. I never had anyone that I could be like that. Being 15 years old, living in America, I can't tell you there is a character that I was like, I could play her. Unless it's a white role, because usually that's the lead. Not because I want to be a white girl. It's because that's the usual lead. Like, why aren't our stories important too? You know, we deserve representation as well. Like in Clueless, like, why couldn't I be, you know, why can a Latina play that role? You know what I mean? Like, that's the movies that I used to watch, you know, growing up. Like, movies like that, those, you know, I just don't understand. I never understood, but it was this passion that I really wanted to make it. You know, the moment that I wanted to be an actress and a singer was when I saw The Bodyguard. And I was mesmerized by her singing, and even though it was in Spanish, I fell in love with, you know, theater and music, and that's the reason why I wanted to become, you know, an actress and singer. I don't know, maybe it was, let me say Whitney Houston is somebody, I guess, but nobody that, she didn't look like me. It felt impossible. It really did feel impossible, but it was a dream that I wanted, and my mother said, you know what, if you really want that, let me put you in classes and vocal lessons and acting classes. Let me see if you got what it takes, you know? And I really wanted to do it, so I started learning how to act and sing, and I played the saxophone and dance and everything in a school in the Dominican Republic called Centro de la Cultura. And yeah, but again, it was just a dream.